differential analyzer, it has to do with differential equations, and differential equation is an equation involving unknown functions and its derivatives. And I haven't taken that class before, so. And differential equations plays a crucial role in physics, engineering, chemistry, economics, and many other things. And the equations are relevant whether a function expresses continuously changing quantities along some rate of change. And there's simple differential equations that are expressed by compact and explicit formulas, and two of those are the sine function and the Bessel functions. And this is an example of one. And a Bessel functions are solutions to specific differential equations, and when graphed, they resemble rippling, decaying sinusoidal waves, and they're useful for solving spatial problems that employ spherical or cylindrical coordinates. And in like that picture, you can see the rippling in it. And then this is an example of a differential equation problem. A differential analyzer was made and like discovered by Vannevar Bush and his colleagues in 1927, and he was a professor at MIT. And it's an analog computer with a wheel and disk components that could solve integration problems, differential equations with several independent variables. And it was the first advanced computer to be used for practical applications. And then this is the picture of it from the book. And how he came up with this idea was that he spent 1 month on one problem, and he decided to make a machine, an analog computer, to solve these problems. And it has five different parts. It has two or more integrator units, which is like the top picture. And then it has adding and counting units, input and output tables, and gearing and shafting system to link everything together. And then this is a picture of the torque amplifier, which is part of the integrator. And two earlier units is, it started out with the harmonic analyzer in 1876, and then it went to the differential analyzer in 1927, and it ended with the ENIAC. And those are both pictures that can be found in the book. And then over the years, there's been many different applications of this, like soil erosion, the building of blueprints for dam and design bombs to destroy German dams during World War II. And in most of my sources, I found information about it being used during World War II. And it's also featured in the science film from 1956, Earth versus the Flying Saucers. And some facts, it was the main tool for calculating differential equations from 1930 to 1950. There's many different machines that have been produced, and the most sophisticated was the RDA2, which is the Rockefeller Differential Analyzer, and it was produced by Vannevar Bush and a group of his colleagues, but it was funded by Rockefeller during World War II. And they found some problems, was that it required you to dismantle and recreate all the gearing mechanisms in the mill machine. And the problem with this was you had to use wrenches and other tools, and if you didn't tighten one good enough one time, it wouldn't get the results you needed. So solution, they replaced the torque amplifier with sensors that could detect the rotations, the integration shaft, edge wheel, values to other parts of the machine, and when they came up with that, they didn't have that problem anymore. And then in his essay in 1945, As We May Think, this is a quote from the Pickover book. It is a far cry from an abacus to the modern keyboard accounting machine. It will be equal step to arithmetical machine of the future. Relief must be secured from laborious, detailed manipulation of high mathematics. Men's spirit can be elevated. So it went from an abacus, which is like what Sienna talked about in her first presentation, to the modern keyboard accounting machine. And he also talks about his visions of a Mnemex, which is a futuristic machine that would enhance human memory by allowing humans to store and retrieve information linked by associations in a manner similar to hypertext on the web today. And there's my sources.